Welcome back to another keyboard modding video, because I have a lot of switches that I need to mod and I want to spread them out evenly. So about a month ago I looted my Aqua Kings and I have about 3 more to go, which I will not leak, but in this video you'll know. And today I'll be looting Glorious Lynx. And you know I own Glorious Pandas too, and I really wanted the Glorious Lynx and I found out that they were being released. So I kind of bought them about a week after they launched with G-Loop. So I've been looting with G-Loop for the first time in my life, and I hopefully want to know that I'll go like Tritox, and I have the G-Loop right here, in fact. Pretty nice. And also I have the Glorious Lynx that I did not unbox. I've had these for about 2 months now. My patience is very good, so I can finally mod them in this video. So now let's do that.
So here we are with the Glorious Lynx. As you know, I've had Glorious Pandas before. I was actually going to make a video on the Glorious Pandas, but I accidentally deleted the files, which is not great, and I really hate myself when I learned that. So luckily today, this time I'll hopefully not mess up, and these are the unlubed version. Yes, Glorious now makes lube pre-lube switches, which I will not buy because I hate pre-lube. So anyways, no, I can unbox them, and I've never actually done these before, so yeah. And they have a nice looking housing. These look like Otemu Skies, but more premium, I guess. That's a business card that's kind of messed up. Nice. And a nice looking sticker. Epic. Now I can open the second box. Second thing, I guess. Yep. Otemu Skies, but cheap. I mean, it's more premium and the sticker and thing again. Yeah, nice. More Glorious boxes for me to take, and the back is just reviews, I think. I don't know. Why would the bags always be like this? This is actually shit, but yeah. I am struggling. Nice. These actually look pretty cool, if I want to be honest. And one flew away. Next month I might have a sneak peek of my next switches, maybe a Gatron switch, but you don't know what, so yeah. The thing is scratchy, not a very heavy spring, it feels pretty light, but eh, whatever, time to loop these. So after I have these really nice looking switches, and shit, I messed up the lighting. Okay, that's better. So these are very nice looking switches, although I must say they kind of look like the cheap Otemu Blues. I mean, some Scots, what am I saying? Alright, time to open these up. And luckily, they use cherry style. And I need to open 61 of these, so it's time for me to go. Oh my god, I haven't set up my Asian rice bowls. Shit. Oh, the spring silver. Wish it was gold. Too bad, not everything can be gold. Wait, I'm still recording this in normal video. Hold on, this will be a time lapse. So I've opened up all 61 I needed, and oops. Yes, I've opened up 61 of these switches. As you can see, they have a really nice teal body that I really like. White, clearish stems and normal springs, and I need to bag loop the springs and set these up for lubing. So I put all the springs in the bag for some oil. Now I just have to rub the oil all over and shake it up. Nice. And no, I am not a fan of cutter switch. I just said that because yes. So after a few minutes of shaking, I got all the springs covered in oil. And now I can go on to lubing the actual switches. The most painful part, but who cares? I don't really know if this is even enough, but I can always guess. Honestly, I love having this switch thing to be my lubing station now, because having a nine switch one was kind of painful because for time and It held on way too tightly, but these are much more easy to put in and out. Don't quote me, please. Yeah. Ah, perfection right there. Looks really nice. Now we can get my G-lube. My brush. And this stem holder. Nice. Now we can start the lubing process. Magic. Not really magic, but yeah, you might get the point. Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me. To those shining stars, he said, go venture far beyond the shores. Don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just a kid, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said, one day you'll leave this world behind. So live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me. I have lubed all 61 of the Glorious Lynx. It was painful, but great. And now here's my board, which at the moment has my Telios again. And I love the feeling of them. Like, very satisfying. That's why I love them. So anyways, I have to pull off all these keycaps now and put my Glorious Lynx onto them. And see you in a bit after that suffering ends. So after redoing my board, we got it back. And now I have to install the links and the keycaps, so I'm just gonna snap to that time frame because I am bored of recording time lapses of putting switches and keycaps on after past experience. Cough, cough. So I have installed all the Glorious links now. I tested the keys. I think they're all nice sounding. Although I find the spring kind of light, but yeah. If you're wondering why the blue looks different each time I move it around, it's because of my lamp. So yeah, now we'll put on the keycaps. The totally legit GMK. Let's fucking go. I guess these are pretty good switches.
So I've been using these switches for a month now because I got lazy and filming this video. So it took me over a month just to record the last bit of the video, goddammit. So in conclusion, these switches are great for the value. They are a very good beginner switch, but not the best switch for a more experienced type of person with makeup keyboards. Actuation was a bit light. It was probably around like 45 grams or 55 grams, I can't remember, but they were very light compared to my other switches. The sound was pretty nice actually, but too loud and clacky for my preference. But overall, they were a pretty nice switch to type on. Definitely pissed off my ELA class for sure. Thanks, Glorious Lynx. They were pretty nice to lube in general. I think it gave a big improvement, but in conclusion, they were a pretty okay switch. Not my favorite, but you know what? They did a pretty good job. So that's the end of my another keyboard video that hopefully will take not another month to make another one. And see you guys in the next keyboard video, if I even can make one on time.